At the time of the Great Famine, most Irish people were poor peasants. They rented land from wealthy English landlords and lived in simple cottages such as the one in this photo. A whole family would often live in one room with pigs and other farm animals. The potato was the staple diet for poor Irish peasants. In 1845, a disease called potato blight struck. Potatoes became soggy and rotten and smelled badly. It was not possible to eat them. This photo shows what a blighted potato looks like. The potato blight meant that poor families had little or no food to eat, and they could not pay rent to the landlord. Many families were evicted from their homes by wealthy landlords. They had no food, no money, and no home. Starving, desperate people flocked to the workhouse. In the workhouse, families were often separated and never saw each other again. Many people emigrated to America or Canada on ships. This photo shows what the ships looked like. They had to cross the Atlantic Ocean in rough seas and sometimes stormy weather. The journey could take months. Conditions on board the ships were often very poor. Ships were hugely overcrowded. Starving and dying people slept beside strangers. There was not much food, water, or fresh air. Disease spread. So many passengers died on the journey across the ocean that the ships became known as coffin ships. It was not uncommon for children's parents, brothers, or sisters to die on the journey. For the people who survived the journey, the destination represented hope and a new life. However, Irish immigrants were not always welcome in the new land because they were homeless and brought disease with them. Statues of the famine victims can be seen in Dublin today. They stand as a monument and a reminder of the people who died and emigrated during the Great Famine in Ireland. The statues remind us of the suffering of the people